Hi, I'm Nikki, and welcome to Movie Talk. This time, I want to talk about the 4K format.
Most people are probably familiar with 4K by now, since most new televisions today have 4K resolution. This is the resolution of HD, which is also used for Blu-ray. 4K means that the resolution is 4 times higher than HD, so that's a lot.
To take advantage of a 4K TV, we of course need 4K content. So a new physical media came along last year in 2016. The format is called Ultra HD Blu-ray. Yeah, I wish they worked a bit more on the name. But that's the official name, Ultra HD Blu-ray. Even though the front says 4K Ultra HD, which is a bit confusing. But let's take a look at this new format. To really show you the difference between HD and 4K, this entire video is in 4K as well.
First time I heard about 4K TVs, I thought it was a bit overkill having a 4K resolution in the living room, since HD is already crystal clear to look at. To really take advantage of the 4K resolution, you need a big screen, and you need to sit pretty close to the TV. I bought a 65-inch 4K TV a few months ago, and a Samsung Ultra HD Blu-ray player, along with 8 movies. So now I'm ready to review this format. First, let me take you back 11 years. When the Blu-ray disc arrived in 2006, everyone was blown away by the crystal clear HD quality. There was a big difference between DVD and Blu-ray, since the resolution of Blu-ray is almost 6 times higher than DVD. I immediately started to clear out my DVDs and replacing them with Blu-rays.
So the big question is 4K movies worth it? Should you start buying 4K movies now instead of regular Blu-rays? Well, the resolution of 4K is 4 times higher than HD, as I mentioned, so there should be a big difference. Let's take a look.
This is The Revenant from 2015 in 4K. This was the very first movie I bought. And I was pretty confused when I first put on this movie. I don't really see the big difference. Is this really 4K? I'm not really blown away. When I look closely, the 4K picture is a bit sharper, but it's not that much. The only real difference is the color grading. Let's put on Warcraft the Beginning from 2016. Well, I still don't see a big difference. Without the comparison, I wouldn't be able to tell if I was watching HD or 4K. Let's zoom in 400%. Yeah, the 4K picture is a bit sharper, but still not that much. It should be 4 times sharper. It even says so on the box. So what's wrong here? No matter which of my 8 movies I put on, the difference is very small. I can't really tell the difference between 4K movies and regular Blu-rays. So that's disappointing. So I started to do some research, and I quickly found an answer to why I don't see a big difference. It turns out that most movies still to this day are only mastered in 2K resolution, which is pretty much the same resolution as a standard HD Blu-ray. The difference is very small. Many movies are shot in 4K resolution or higher, but are usually mastered in 2K.
This just blows my mind. Most Hollywood movies are only mastered in 2K. When we go to the cinema, it's usually just 2K resolution. Then why do we need 4K movies at home then? It's just upscale 2K content anyway, so what's the point? It's kind of false advertisement.
You're probably wondering why Hollywood movies are still using the 2K format. The answer is pretty simple. It's because of CGI. Almost every movie today has CGI in it. And CGI is expensive, it requires a lot of computer power, and it takes a lot of time to render. Here's some examples. The movie Frozen by Pixar from 2013 had 50 effects artists working on the single shot in which Elsa builds her ice palace. And it took 30 hours to render each frame for the shot, with 4,000 computers rendering one frame at a time. The CGI black hole in Interstellar from 2014 took 120 hours per frame to render. That's 5 days to render a single frame for the movie. And a movie runs at 24 frames per second, by the way, so that's just insane.
Imagine how much computer power and how much time it would take to render all effects in 4K instead. So yeah, that's why most movies are mastered in 2K.
There are some real 4K movies though, and it's usually movies with less CGI. This is Sully from 2016, and this movie is supposedly mastered in 4K, and the visual effects should be rendered in 4K too. Well, I guess the picture is a bit sharper, but still not a huge difference. I was hoping for a lot more. There is a website to help people find out what movies are worth watching in 4K. The movies are divided between real 4K and fake 4K. And there's a third category called nearly 4K, which means that the movies are partially in 4K, which is a bit confusing. For example, I have The Amazing Spider-Man 2. It's been mastered in 4K, but the visual effects are rendered in 2K. I should mention that besides the resolution, the new 4K format also offers movies with high dynamic range, or HDR, which means that the colors are better and the contrast is deeper. But for the most part, I don't find it very interesting, and I think most people won't see a lot of difference. I mainly care about the higher resolution. When Blu-ray was introduced in 2006, it also offered better colors than DVD, which was nice, but people mainly cared about the higher resolution.
So my final judgment is this. It's not worth buying a 4K player or 4K movies. Most movies don't take advantage of the 4K resolution. It's just upscale 2K content, which is pretty much the same resolution as standard HD Blu-rays. So I'm very disappointed in this new format. We shouldn't switch to 4K until Hollywood completely switches to 4K as well. Now, even though I think 4K movies are not worth it, that doesn't mean that 4K TVs are not worth it.
A lot of YouTube videos are in 4K, and they look amazing on a 4K TV. And if you happen to own a video camera that shoots in 4K, the footage looks gorgeous on a 4K TV as well. This is my own 4K video camera. I recorded footage with my camera in both HD and 4K, and there's a big difference in the picture quality. Look at the clarity in the 4K picture. It looks a lot better. This is what it looks like with 400% zoom. Look at the details in the 4K picture compared to HD. This is the resolution I was hoping for with 4K movies.
As many of you know, I was just in Hawaii to make a video about the filming locations of Jurassic Park, and we shot the whole video in 4K, and the footage looks amazing, and I can't wait for you guys to see the final video. Even our drone footage is in 4K.
I remember when DVD came in the late 90s. Everybody loved this new format and quickly dropped the old VHS technology. But for a couple of years, all movies were released on both DVD and VHS, until VHS eventually died out and everything was just released on DVD. In 2006, Blu-ray was introduced. Blu-ray became popular for its crystal clear HD resolution, but a lot of people were satisfied with the DVD format and stuck with it. And DVD never died out. It's now 2017, and DVD has been coexisting with Blu-ray for 11 years so far, and there seem to be just as many DVDs as Blu-rays in stores. And now the 4K format is out too. So now we have three different physical medias, which is crazy. I don't think Ultra HD Blu-ray will ever be popular, especially when a lot of people still buy DVDs. The format has been out for a year now, and I don't know anybody but myself who own 4K movies, and I won't be buying any more of them.
Anyway, that was my review of Ultra HD Blu-ray. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, and I'll see you next time.